What's the world today? You know, today when we hear about what's happening in the world, there are a lot of question marks. Okay, why is this happening like this? And who's going to change the world? But what is the world? The world is a collective consciousness. Let's say this room. Suppose we're 500 sitting in this room. So the energy of this room is the total of 500 minds. So who's contributing to the energy of this room? Each one of us. So each one of us is responsible for what the energy of this room is. So we contribute to the energy of the room, and we also get influenced by the energy of the room. So similarly, now expand this 500 to the entire planet. So what's the energy of the planet? State of mind of each one of us. So we all are responsible for the state of the world today by what we are inside. So all the minds put together is what's the vibration of the world. So if I want to change my world, I will have to change the part of my mind. So if my mind says kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ahankar, that is lust, anger, greed, ego, jealousy is normal, then that's what I'm going to see in the world. So when I read something like this happening out in the world, whether it is related to lust, whether it is related to terror, whether it's related to greed, corruption, whether it is exploitation of environment, and I say, how can they do this? I need to pause and check. I contributed to it also by creating it here. Shifting our sanskars to our original sanskars of purity, peace, love, happiness, power, knowledge, and bliss, which we say Satoguni Atma. Satoguni Atma means every soul is made of seven qualities. That's the innate of every soul on the planet. So it's like white, this was the original color, but then kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ahankar stains. But they are only a stain. They are not who we are. It's only a stain. But since many of us have that stains, then that's what we see in the world. Now, most important, we don't need everybody to clean the stain. We need a small number, which is called the tipping point. If a small number of us change our consciousness and shift from lust to purity, purity in our thoughts, purity in our attitude, purity in the way we look at each other. And purity means no barriers of gender, no barriers of even nationality, no barriers of caste and creed, but I am a consciousness talking to another consciousness. I'm an energy talking to another energy. So that's purity, where I'm not seeing you through any other barriers of what you have acquired in this lifetime. Leave alone your name, fame, possession, property. Nothing at all. Just for who you are. So I've shifted towards purity. Shifting from krodh, anger, to peace. Now, if each one of us takes this up, that tomorrow, the entire day, I will use peace in my every interaction and no anger and irritation. We would have contributed towards creating peace in the world tomorrow. But if we keep saying anger is normal, then we are contributing to the terror in the world. So all these five vices need to be replaced with our seven original qualities, and that means we've shifted in our sanskar. So we are shifting from a gusse ka sanskar, anger, to shanti ka sanskar, sanskar of peace. When I shift, my world starts shifting. My world first is my mind, my body, my relationships, my workplace. That's my world. And then the ripples vibrating out into the world. So jab sanskar badalte hain, to sansar badal jata hai. So sanskar and sansar is directly connected. Our world is only a reflection of our state of mind. Clean the mind and the world is a beautiful place to live in. So when we work on our sanskars, the world will change.